ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن شاء الله. A short reminder, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst their ibad, his ibad, his slaves. As Allah says in Surah Zumar, فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادَ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلِ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَا. Give glad tidings to my slaves, they are those who listen, not just listen, but they listen attentively, and then they implement what they have heard in the best way possible. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst his ibad, Ameer Rabbil Alameen. When we say the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we learn about his akhlaq. We learn the importance of exhibiting and bringing the akhlaq of the Prophet sallallahu into our life. But when you say the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we learn that there were some characteristics that he had prior to prophethood. Prior to prophethood, and the ulama, sometimes they expand upon them and they highlight those. Why? Because you can be as far as you want to be from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but these are some characteristics that every single individual we need to exhibit. Unfortunately, these are the same characteristics today that are lost, not only in the Muslim community, but across the world. But we don't focus on the entire world, we focus on what is going on in our own Muslim community. What is going on in my life? What is going on within my own society? For example, one of the things that we learn from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is this ability to stand up for justice. When he saw someone that was a victim of oppression, no matter how insignificant that oppression may be, never did the Prophet ﷺ just sit back and he gave it to someone else. The Prophet ﷺ would stand up himself and he would fight on behalf of that person. And subhanAllah, the Prophet ﷺ was so unselfish that after even helping that person, he will never tell that person, I helped you, now you listen to me and you listen to the message of Islam. This is how unselfish Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was. And what we learn from this is this, that today when we see injustices taking place, sometimes we step forward. Why? Because I want them to become a Muslim. That is not the reason why we step forward. We step forward as Muslims and we fight against injustice because this is who Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was. But today I want to highlight another characteristic of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that was, subhanAllah, even before he received wahi, he had this reputation in the community of being as-sadiq al-amin. If you want to summarize these characteristics of the Prophet in one word, it is honesty. When I say the word honesty, the very first thing that comes to my mind and your mind is that honesty when we converse with each other. First of all, is that when we talk to each other, honesty has to be there. It is not fitting for a Muslim, a person who believes in Allah, who believes in the last day, who believes in Rasulullah ﷺ, who tries to emulate Rasulullah ﷺ, that they would deceive anyone else. In fact, Rasulullah ﷺ said himself, "Man ghashana falaysa minna." Anyone who deceives others, anyone who betrays others, they're not from amongst us. Because the Prophet ﷺ always promoted the idea of being truthful. The Prophet ﷺ always promoted the idea of being upfront, being straightforward, not being disrespectful. When I say the word straightforward, it does not mean that you go and you be disrespectful to someone and you degrade them. That's not what the Prophet ﷺ was. That's not what he promoted. But he promoted honesty. Honesty and when we talk to each other. Today, subhanAllah, we live in a society. Today, still in America, it is still somewhat better. But subhanAllah, you look at our Muslim countries. I'm not going to take names of Muslim countries because any of us can get offended. But our Muslim countries, subhanAllah, for the most part, when you go there, when you try to talk to people, when you see, it's hard to even exhibit honesty nowadays. This is what the Muslim world has become. When I say honesty, it does not only mean when I talk to each other. Honesty also extends to business. When I work with each other, when I engage in financial transactions with others, subhanAllah, how many times do we hear in a community, one person cheated another person, one person cheated another person, one person took a loan from another person and decided not to give that back. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the story about these people who were in Medina. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ يَسْتَوْفُونَ وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ يُخْسِرُونَ. When they demanded, they always demanded in full. But when it came time to give, they would always give less. Allah says, أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ. Have these people not realized that they will have to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You may deceive someone else today. You may get your way around. But you cannot, none of us can deceive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I stand before Allah, Allah knows who I am. Allah knows all the tricks I have in my bag, the tricks I would use against other people, the way I would cheat other people. I cannot cheat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Honesty in talking, in conversing, honesty in business, even honesty when it comes to even giving advice. How many times the Prophet ﷺ has taught us, Jarir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhu, hadith found in Bukhari and Muslim, muttafaq alayh. He says, بَايَعْتُ عَلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ. I took allegiance on Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, on the hands of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, على إقام الصلاة, on the establishment of prayer, وَإِيْتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ, and giving my zakah, وَالنُّصْحِ لِكُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ, and giving sincere advice, and being sincere to other people. We learn Sheikh bin Baz, rahmatullahi alayh, he gives his own definition of what sincere advice is. He says, هُوَ الْإِخْلَاصُ فِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. It is ikhlas in everything that you do. And he says, وَعَدَمُ الْغَشِّ وَالْخِيَانَةِ فِيهِ. And it is to remove any kind of deceit or betrayal when you're giving advice to others. SubhanAllah, when it comes to us giving advice to others, we give advice, but when it comes to our own self, we always cut out and we always remove. And we sometimes, it's okay, one is that you don't mention something, that's one thing. But one is that you give wrong advice because you don't want that person to move ahead of you in this dunya. This is not from the nature of a Muslim. So subhanAllah, one thing that we have to all do, brothers and sisters, is this concept of honesty, subhanAllah, it is lost within the ummah today. We have to revive this. This is once again, not even about Rasulullah Sallam being honest after prophethood. He was an honest person before prophethood, meaning that this is something that we need to really build within our life. And at the end of the day, it's our children who see us. When our children see that someone is calling and I tell my child to lie, what example am I giving to my child? Today we teach our own children that if you can go and make a fool out of someone, if you can go and lie to someone, if you can go and deceive someone, you can go and betray someone, mashallah, you are very smart. This is a person who has street smart. This is wrong. Wallahi, this is wrong. There is nothing wrong in being street smart. You can be street smart and you can be smart and intelligent, and you don't have to betray people, and you don't have to lie to other people, and you don't have to deceive other people. But why? These are the things that today we're teaching our children. I understand that we live today in a very unfair, we live in a very dishonest world, but that does not mean that I have the right and that gives me permission to then deceive others and betray others. So this is why, subhanAllah, we find even the story of Shu'aib alayhi salam. This is one thing that he really, again, he hit home so many times. Every single prophet that came, they realized that there was a major issue within the qabila or within the nation that they were sent to. When it came to Shu'aib alayhi salam, he realized that when it came to business, they would deceive others. There was a lack of honesty in their life. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who are honest. And we have to really bring this into our families, bring this into our life, exhibit this in our own life, so that even our children, inshallah, they will have honesty. If they keep on, think about it, a person who keeps on lying, who keeps on deceiving others, keeps on betraying others, how can this person come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You want to sit here, you want to come to the masjid, and you feel like, and any, not just you, I mean any one of us, we feel like that I pray to Allah, I do all this, but on the side, if I'm doing this, wallahi, it's going to destroy what we're doing. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who are honest, to raise us on the day of judgment amongst those who are honest. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.